وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى the tafsir of today will بإذن الله الكريم be regarding the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا وَارْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ مَنْ آمَنَ وَارْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ مَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ قَالَ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَأُمَتِّعُهُ قَلِيلًا ثُمَّ أَضْطَرُّهُ إِلَى عَذَابِ النَّارِ ثُمَّ أَضْطَرُّهُ إِلَى عَذَابِ النَّارِ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. وَإِذْ here it means وَذْكُرْ, remember. Know. وَذْكُرْ دَعْوَةُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ, remember the supplication, the invoking of Ibrahim alayhi salam, بِحُلُولِ الْأَمْنِ الدَّائِمِ لِلْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينِ, when he sought, he begged Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for what? To give continuous safety to Balad al-Haram, Mecca. He begged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what Ibn Jarir al-Tabari and Ibn Kathir and Sa'di and Ibn Ashur all mentioned, rahimahumullah. Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, he mentions in a hadith al-Imam Muslim narrated, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, inna Ibrahim harrama Makkata. Ibrahim, due to him, Mecca was made sacred. وَإِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ الْمَدِينَةَ مَا بَيْنَ لَابَتَيْهَا. And I, Nabi Allah Muhammad, through me, Medina was made, it was made a sacred land. And the Prophet then gave us the exact part that is referred to as Al-Madina. He says, بَيْنَ لَابَتَيْهَا. لَابَتَيْهَا, it means بَيْنَ حَرَّتَيْهَا. يعني من جانبيها, from the two sides. Because Medina is between بين حرتين. And the word الحرة, it's هي الأرض ذات الحجارة السود. It's the land where the rocks and the pebbles are dark, they're black. حافظ بن حجر mentions that in his فتح الباري. And also المصباح المنير الفيومي, that's what he mentions, that the word لابتيها means. إذن Medina is between, it's between those two labatain that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned. So what the Prophet here is saying alayhi salatu wasalam is that this is what Medina is. Ibrahim did that for Mecca, and I, on the other hand, Nabila Muhammad, wa inni haramtu al-Madinata ma bayna labatayha la yuqta'u ghidahuha. It's ghidahuha is not cut. The word al-ghidah, it is kullu shajarin azimin lahu shawkun. That's what Ibn Athir mentions in his Niyaya. It's every tree that has a lot of leaves and etc. Okay? That is what it means. وَلَا يُصَادُ صَيْدُهَا. And its livestock is not hunted. Abdullah ibn Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَرَّمَ مَكَّةَ وَدَعَى لَهَا. That Ibrahim, because of him, Mecca was made a sacred land. وَدَعَ لَهَا, and he supplicated for it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَحَرَّمْتُ الْمَدِينَةَ كَمَا حَرَّمَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ مَكَّةَ. I, on the other hand, I, because of me, Medina was made a sacred land. And Ibrahim did it for Mecca as I did it for Medina. وَدَعَوْتُ لَهَا, and I made dua for Medina. فِي مُدِّهَا وَصَاعِهَا. And the mud and the sa' are types of measurements that I used to measure food. Okay? مثل ما دعا إبراهيم عليه السلام لمكة. And I made the same supplication that Ibrahim made for Mecca, I made it for Medina. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this in a hadith Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih. So Medina is the same that which has been said for Mecca. Okay? In other words, this dua that Ibrahim here made, Rabbi ja'al hadha baladan aminan, Nabi Muhammad made a similar dua like that for Medina and its people. وَرَزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ مَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Allah mentions here that Ibrahim alayhi salam, he asked his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala that he provides the mu'mini ahli Makkah, that he provides for the believers of Mecca, that Allah provides from them what? مِنْ أَنْوَاعِ الثِّمَارِ الْمُخْتَلِفَةِ, the different types of vegetations and fruits that Allah provides them and gives to them subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Qasas, أَوَلَمْ نُمَكِّنْ لَهُمْ حَرَمًا آمِنًا يُجِبَى إِلَيْهِ ثَمَرَاتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ رِزْقًا مِنْ لَدُنَّهِ. Allah mentions it as a blessing that He did for them subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He gave them safety and He subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them different types of vegetation. This is the middle of the desert and all different types of vegetations were coming to them because of their travelings, رِحَلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. Okay? That's for the believers. As for the disbelievers, قَالَ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَأُمَتِّعْهُ قَلِيلًا. The one who is a kafir, okay, what should happen for him? إِنَّ الْكَافِرَ يَنَالُ رِزْقَهُ. Let the kafir also gain rizq from this. Like a rizq which is dunyawi, worldly provisions. Let him gain it from there أيضًا. Because why? The dunya is a short period of time. So let him enjoy it as well with the believers, okay? But do not, Ya Rabbi, give it to him in the hereafter. Because that one, it's da'imun bilan qita'in wala nihaya. It doesn't come to an end and it's consistent and it will carry on. ثُمَّ أَضَّرُّهُ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ النَّارِ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرِ. And then after that, oh Allah, push him. يعني the disbeliever, give him the provision in this world. But the hereafter, أَلْجِئُهُ وَأَدْفَعْهُ. Oh Allah, throw him and push him towards, whilst he's refusing, وَهُوَ مُكْرَهُنِ. While he's refusing, oh Allah, take him to the hellfire. Because he refused to be a believer whilst he was on this earth. And then look what he said, وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. يعني وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ means, أي وَسَاءَ الْمَصِيرُ. What a bad place that it is to go to the hellfire. عَذَابُ النَّارِ is a very bad place to go to. And Allah mentioned it in a few places in the Quran. Allah mentions it subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Muhammad. He also subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Luqman. Allah says in Surah Muhammad, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يَتَمَتَّعُونَ وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَنْعَامُ وَالنَّارُ مَثْوًا لَهُمْ. The disbelievers are going to enjoy themselves in this dunya. They're going to eat, they're going to drink, they're going to fulfill their desires, they're going to have children and everything. Allah will give it to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then the day of judgment, وَالنَّارُ مَثْوًا لَهُمْ. The hellfire is their final abode. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَنْ كَفَرَ, anyone who disbelieves, فَلَا يَحَزُنْكَ كُفْرُهُ إِلَيْنَا مَرْجِعُهُمْ فَنُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا ثُمَّ نَضَّرُّهُمْ إِلَىٰ عَذَابٍ غَلِيظٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here, anyone who disbelieves, don't let it sadden you, their disbelief. They're going to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will inform them of everything. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا, everything they did. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. He even knows what's in their chests. He doesn't even need to ask them subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah says, نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا. We're going to allow them to enjoy themselves for a short period of time. ثُمَّ نَضَّرُّهُمْ أي ثُمَّ نَدْفَعُهُمْ. We're going to push them. Whilst they are what? وَهُمْ مُكْرَهُونَ. While refusing, they will be pushed to what? إِلَىٰ عَذَابٍ غَلِيظٍ. To a severe place. They're going to be pushed to a severe place. A place they wouldn't like. A place they would not enjoy. A place they would not like. I'm going to conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.